Matthew chapter 14. At that time, Herod the Tetrarch heard the news about Jesus and said to his servants, "This is John the Baptist. He is risen from the dead. And that is why miraculous powers work in him. For when Herod had John arrested, he bound him and put him in prison on account of Herodias, the wife of his brother Philip. For John had been saying to him, 'It is not lawful for you to have her.' And although he wanted to put him to death, he feared the multitude because they regarded him as a prophet. But when Herod's birthday came, the daughter of Herodias danced before them and pleased Herod. Thereupon he promised with an oath to give her whatever she asked. And having been prompted by her mother, she said, 'Give me here on a platter the head of John the Baptist.' And although he was grieved, the king commanded him to be given because of his oaths and because of his dinner guests. And he sent and had John beheaded in the prison, and his head was brought on a platter and given to the girl, and she brought it to her mother. And his disciples came and took away the body and buried it, and they went and reported to Jesus. Now when Jesus heard it, he withdrew from there and went to a lonely place by himself. And when the multitude heard this, they followed him on foot from the cities. And when he went ashore, he saw a great multitude and felt compassion for them and healed their sick. And when it was evening, the disciples came to him saying, 'The place is desolate, and the time is already past. So send the multitudes away that they may go in the villages and buy food for themselves.' But Jesus said to them, 'They do not need to go away. You give them something to eat.' They said to him, 'We have here only 5 loaves and 2 fish. And he said, 'Bring them here to me.' And ordering the multitudes to recline the grass, he took the 5 loaves and 2 fish, and looking up toward heaven, he blessed the food, and breaking the loaves, he gave them to the disciples, and the disciples gave the multitudes. And they all ate and were satisfied, and they picked up what was left of the broken pieces, 12 full baskets. And there were about 5,000 men who ate, aside from women and children. And immediately he made the disciples get into the boat and go ahead of him to the other side while he sent the multitudes away. And after he sent the multitudes away, he went up the mountain by himself to pray. And when it was evening, he was there alone. But the boat was already many stadia away from the land, battered by the waves, for the wind was contrary. And in the fourth watch of the night, he came to them walking on the sea. And when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were frightened, saying, 'It is a ghost,' and they cried out for fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them, saying, 'Take courage, it is I, do not be afraid.' And Peter answered him and said, 'Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water.' And he said, 'Come.' And Peter got out of the boat and walked on the water and came toward Jesus. But seeing the wind, he became afraid, and beginning to sink, he cried out, saying, 'Lord, save me.' And immediately Jesus stretched out his hand and took hold of him and said to him, 'O you of little faith, why did you doubt?' And when they got in the boat, the wind stopped. And those who were in the boat worshipped him, saying, 'You are certainly God's son.' And when they had crossed over, they came to land at Gennesaret. And when the men of that place recognized him, they sent in all that surrounding district and brought to him all who were sick. And they began to entreat him that they might just touch the fringe of his cloak, and as many as touched it were cured.